Welcome to Dell Technologies PowerProtect version 19.8 how-to series. PowerProtect version 19.8 PowerProtect Data Manager reporting to CloudIQ. Reference Dell Knowledge Article number 18566 9. This video was created to introduce the latest PowerProtect Data Manager reporting feature CloudIQ, and to demonstrate how to use CloudIQ. This video presents the following: what is CloudIQ, how to use CloudIQ, and explain the tabs found within CloudIQ. What is CloudIQ? CloudIQ is a reporting tool used in various products in Dell Technologies, and in the coming days, PowerProtect will be joining in reporting via CloudIQ, instead of using PowerProtect Central. This is a demonstration on how to use CloudIQ. When you click the reporting button in the PowerProtect Data Manager GUI, it will direct you to CloudIQ tool. This is the overview of CloudIQ GUI. Here is the connectivity to CloudIQ, which shows the status of connectivity of local systems to CloudIQ, which means you'll be able to see whether the systems are connected, or lost their connection, or not yet set. And when you click on any of them, you'll be able to know the product's name and family type. And when you go back to the overview, you'll be able to see the critical alerts, errors and warnings in the system alerts section. And by clicking on Go to Alerts, you can find further information about these errors. When you go back to the overview, you click on Inventory, then choose Systems. You then choose Data Protection tab, and you scroll down till you find your PowerProtect. Here you can see the summary of your PowerProtect. In the Data Protection section, you will find the protected assets and their capacity, as well as the unprotected assets and their capacity. Please note that this section will only appear if you're using PowerProtect version 19.5 or higher. In the Protection Summary section, you'll find all the activities done up to 7 days prior. And here is the Compliance Summary section. And here in the Asset Top Offenders section, you will find the assets that have consecutive failure, and by clicking on it, you will find further details concerning the failure. And here is the Protection tab. You can find all the protected assets, which different aspects can be filtered using the filtration feature. And here is the final tab, which is the Compliance tab. This tab shows different assets, and the details of the error, in case a failure occurred. You can also use the filtration feature to facilitate your reporting process. Reference the following for more information: KB number 185669. Thank you for watching.